World Uyghur Congress established in 2004 April. All the Uyghurs leaders, Uyghur delegation from around the world is coming to the Munich and established World Uyghur Congress. You know, actually before the World Uyghur Congress is have two umbrella organizations in exile. One is East Turkestan in National Congress. Other is World Uyghur Youth Congress. The both is umbrella organization representing the Uyghur, united under the name World Uyghur Congress. Since the established World Uyghur Congress, I'm the Secretary General of the World Uyghur Congress. World Uyghur Congress main object is freedom for Uyghur people in Turkestan, creating democracy and human rights and self-determination for this in Turkestan. It is our main object. Of course, for this object, we use non-violent, peaceful way we want to achieve through the dialogue. World Uyghur Congress want for self-determination right for the Uyghur people because it's a political future for the Turkestan people should be designed, should be determined by the Uyghur people, not by the communist China. So World Uyghur Congress work for this issue. In the exile, the diaspora is majority living in Central Asia, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, and Uzbekistan. Is we believe that more than 1 million Uyghurs population living in the Central Asia. Of course, recently, yes, after especially after the Soviet Union collapse, in the some Uyghur is moved to the Western country, Europe, and United States, Canada, and Australia. So, and now it is a lot of Uyghur organization has been established in several Western country. So, is this all the Uyghurs is coming from new from the Eastern Turkestan around the world. So we believe that this Uyghur can be represented because it's all Uyghurs coming from different of village, different place of the Eastern Turkestan. Most of some Uyghurs who is coming to this Western country is suffering by the Chinese persecutions from China. So and they want to save our life to come to the Western country and the democratic country is sort of political asylum. Yeah. So and establish the organization around the world. So World Uyghur Congress is umbrella organization, holds the Uyghur organization and Uyghur and the representative Uyghur people in exile. So we believe this all the Uyghur who live in different country, who is it coming from directly from Eastern Turkestan, yes. So World Uyghur Congress in representative is all the Uyghurs in exile in Eastern in inside Eastern Turkestan. So we can say the World Uyghur Congress it is have a right to representative holds Eastern Turkestan cause in the international platform. World Uyghur Congress has called the Chinese authority is sit together is through the dialogue we want to solve the problem. We always repeat first Chinese authority should be recognize accept it there is some problem, there is a conflict between Uyghurs, Turkestan people, and communist China, Chinese authority. But China always refused, said it is everything is wonderful in Turkestan. Most of the Uyghurs, most of the Turkestan people is happy under the rule of the communist China. Only a few people, it is only few separatist power, is want to split, want to separate something that like. It is wrong. I believe that most of the majority in Eastern Turkestan want to freedom. It is a cause that what Uyghur Congress push in the, to the international platform, it is the interesting for the majority in Eastern Turkestan. So is Chinese always lying? Actually, Chinese authority know about this situation, but always is China is it is always push open idea and wrong propaganda to the world. Of course, China Chinese authority always refused or recused. China always said, "I have a power, I have a gun, I can do anything what I want." Yes, so always reject to the dialogue to the World Uyghur Congress or the Uyghurs representative. Just use violent want to solve the problem. But it is wrong, you still repeat it, repeat. Chinese authorities should accept and recognize this the conflict between Chinese authorities, Uyghur people, and should be recognized World Uyghur Congress, yes, and we should sit together through the dialogue, solve the problem. Chinese authority is accused the World Uyghur Congress, even me also, is a terrorist organization, me is it as a terrorist. Actually, World Uyghur Congress is legal organization in Germany. We are registered, is we founded in Germany. Germany is a democratic country, in the law of rule country. So is we are all activities is observed by the German authority, yeah. So World Uyghur Congress had very good communication, very good relationship German authority and another in the international NGO, Europa Parliament, or the United States. Yes, so World Uyghur Congress very good image in the international platform. But China always still continue repeat World Uyghur Congress is terrorist organization. Of course, the Chinese eyes is our kind of democratic movement as a terrorist. Yes, as a terrorist. Sometimes Chinese authority accused is as the holiness of Dalai Lama as a terrorist. Yes, our president Mrs. Kadir is five times is nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize. Even China always say is Rabia Kadir's leader of the terrorist organization. Yes, China is continue. It is pressure, but because China want to stop blocked all Uyghur activity in diaspora. You know, is China's authority is always used to violent crackdown every kind of Uyghur peaceful activity inside Eastern Turkestan. Yes, every kind of activities, even is peaceful demonstration, also terrorist activities. All the separatist activities. Yes, China never recognized one of the Uyghur protests, or one of the Uyghur activities is calling democratic activities or something like that. Like, even in 1989, China is Tiananmen students movement is also is cracked down and killed a couple of thousand people there. Yeah, but actually it's whole the world recognized is a democratic students movement, yes. But China is all kind of peaceful activities, just calling terrorist activities or separate activities. So, and the other side, of course, China try to it's all Uyghur activity in exile level as a terrorist organization. But of course, its international community is no what kind of organization of the World Uyghur Congress. The World Uyghur Congress is have very good image, and in the whole the international community is recognized World Uyghur Congress as a in the democratic and in the peaceful organizations. China is use all kind tactic to crack down and stop blocked Uyghur activities in exile. And China sent some spies to the exile, even in Germany and another country. or some Uyghurs visit Eastern Turkestan to visit the family. China use this advantage and force to the Uyghur to become spies. Yes, so it is not new things. We know since several years is China always attempt, always try to send the spies and want to try to get all the informations through the spies. This year in July is one of the spy suspects is Babur Maksud, was arrested in the Sweden. Sweden police is arrested him, and this process is going on still. Accusation is a spy suspect, yes. And in this month, in the German federal police, criminal police is searching several spies' home and arrested, and according to the media report, asked, questioned, and released them. But this process is going on. German authority, German criminal police have a responsibility to protect us. Protect us. Sometimes it is dangerous to telephone. Some is Chinese call us is threatens or life. Yeah, we always is inform this kind of situation to the German police. So we have very good. We are protected by the German police. So it is. I can say it is not new things, but the spies, because China used, because China have a lot of opportunity. They have money. They have used another economic card. Most of the people who live in Western country, all the parents, relatives still living in Eastern Turkestan. Is a pressure is them family and use another way, maybe give them money, and is some of the people, maybe even Uyghurs work for China as spies. In 1997 is February in Ulja. The Uyghurs demand is religion freedom, and the peacefully demonstrate, peacefully gathering. But Chinese police used violent and crack down this demonstrations and arrested a lot of people and killed a lot of demonstrators. Yes. Even already 12 years passed the Hulja event, but most of the people, some of them who is participator for this demonstration still in the jail, still is the people punished by the so-called Chinese court. Yeah, a lot of people were missed, a lot of people were killed. Yes, it is Hulja event. It is peacefully demonstration. Like is 5 July is peaceful demonstration. You know, different of period of time. Eastern Turkestan is happening a lot of peaceful demonstration gathering, but Chinese authority never listen to this voice. Just use violence. Just use weapon to kill, to crack down all the peaceful demonstrator. Yes, if China is some responsible person from the government is listening the voice of these people, is negotiated through the negotiation, can solve the problem. Not necessary to use the violence, but China have no. This is Chinese tolerance from the Chinese authority is zero. This case, they have no Chinese authority, Chinese authority has never try to solve the problem. Just Chinese authority create them this problem. Every event, every time happening such kind of demonstration or some protest, Chinese use this advance, just kill him, arrest him, and campaign, hard strike campaign for the Uyghurs. This time is Ürümqi, during the Ürümqi unrest or Volca demonstrations. Both events, the people gathering and the march to the building, the government's building. It's meaning they have a right to refuse something from the government. But they have no go to the, they never went to the mountain. Or some in the underground organization, or no, they have no attempt to fight to the Chinese military power. They just very peaceful way. This time, Ürümqi Uyghurs even carry the Chinese flag as well. This meaning we are not separatists, we are not terrorists. Yeah, we just demand or refused. But China is shows null tolerance, just you use the violence to kill the people. After this event, World Uyghur Congress, we had reduced, we calling international community or United States or European Parliament should be sent an independent investigation group to the area and investigate and issues the report. Is China said 197 people were killed. Among them is most of them are Chinese. Very small is Uyghurs. Yes, so is Han Chinese are victims. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. If you you are honest, if you honest and you are believe. If not, you are not lying, why you afraid, why you don't allow its independent investigations group come to the area to the investigate? Because China know, it is if some independent investigations group come to the area to the investigate, and every reality should be open, yeah. So China is all this is all that China's it is demand all the Islam. It is not credibility. Just the Xinhua agency is reported all these things. Is China has no any independent media. This Xinhua agency is a propaganda institution for the Chinese Communist Party. China said only 197 people were killed during the march. But according to the information directly from Eastern Turkestan, some of the witness escaped from Eastern Turkestan coming to the other country. The witness provide to us some information. According to the information is couple of thousand people were killed. Yes, not 200 people, but more than 1,000 or 2,000 people were killed during this 5 July, this night. Is in the evening, is Chinese authority cut all the electricity, all the telephone line, just is killed, whole the demonstrator. So it's during this night, is couple of thousand people were killed this night, and yes, it is very difficult to confirm actually how many people were killed, how many people arrested. Yeah, since already 5 months, still is no any telephone and internet communication between Eastern Turkestan to outside the country. Is China afraid if open this internet on telephone communication, and maybe is the world no real situation what was happening with Turkestan? I was invited to South Korea, the World Forum for Democracy in Asia conference. I was invited for this conference to give a speech, give a briefing on the Uyghur human rights issue. But because of some Chinese spies, maybe my guess, some Chinese spies provide the information to the China about my trip to South Korea. Yeah, and it's just Chinese authority is pressure to the South Korea government. So unfortunately, I was stopped in the South Korea border and I was detained 3 days in the Seoul airport. According to some news, Chinese authority recused from the South Korea government. I should send back to the China. Yeah, this case is a lot of discussion between China and South Korea. Of course, I'm the German citizen. I'm the project director. Uyghur Leadership Training Project. This project was supported by NED, is one of the American foundations, National Endowment Democracy. Because of this is a German government, foreign ministry, German ambassador in Seoul, and the US State Department, and US ambassador in Seoul, and some US senator, and the Europa parliament member, and Amnesty International, and other human rights organizations, is a lot of pressure to the South Korea government, and finally South Korea government led me back to safely to Germany.